Second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Transport and Logistics. Deputy President, I move the second reading of the Shipping Legislation, Use of Fuels and Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2024. At the end of last year, the Transport and Logistics Bureau published the Action Plan on Maritime and Port Development Strategy, and one of the strategies is to develop Hong Kong into a green port to enhance competitiveness. In this connection, apart from the green incentive scheme announced by the Marine Department at the end of June to provide incentives to eligible Hong Kong registered ships that have attained a rating of A or B in the Carbon Intensity Indicator CII set by the International Maritime Organization IMO, the development of green maritime fuel bunkering in Hong Kong is also an important measure. Reducing carbon emissions in the maritime industry is an international trend. The IMO has set a target of achieving net zero greenhouse gas emissions from international shipping by or around 2050. As an associate member of the IMO, Hong Kong is obliged to comply with this emission reduction target. In order to achieve the target, the maritime industry has started to gradually adopt low-carbon or even zero-carbon environmentally friendly fuels such as LNG, methanol, ammonia, and hydrogen, hereafter collectively referred to as new fuels, to replace petrol fuels which are commonly used by ships at the moment. With the increasing popularity of green maritime fuels, Hong Kong as an international maritime center must expedite the development of new fuel bunkering to maintain our competitiveness in the maritime field. As the new fuels are different from the existing maritime petroleum fuels in terms of physical and chemical properties, means of carriage, storage and combustion, handling risks, etc., the regulatory approach has to be different from that for traditional petroleum fuels. We will therefore, on the one hand, amend existing legislation to allow the use of new fuels by vessels in Hong Kong waters in addition to traditional maritime petroleum fuels, and ensure that operations are safe and the impact on crew members, vessels, and the environment is minimized. On the other hand, we will implement the technical requirements in relation to the use of new fuels through administrative means such as codes of practice to be gazetted by the Director of Marine, so as to ensure that the regulatory framework will keep abreast of the times and be in line with the new and emerging regulatory standards in the international arena. In drawing up the proposed legislative amendments, we have two principles in mind. First, to allow for the use of new fuels in existing legislation, and second, to incorporate into legislation additional safety and environmental concerns in relation to new fuels. The contents of the legislative proposals can be divided into two main parts. For the first part, we propose to amend the Merchant Shipping Local Vessels Ordinance Chapter 548 to empower the Secretary for Transport and Logistics to make regulations in respect of the use of fuels by local vessels and to make direct reference to the provisions of international agreements applicable to Hong Kong in respect of matters such as the use of fuels by local vessels. For the second part, we propose to amend four pieces of subsidiary legislation to allow vessels to refuel, carry and use new fuels and establish related safety requirements. The government has consulted the Panel on Economic Development as well as the Local Vessels Advisory Committee and the Port Operations Committee of the Marine Department on proposals. Members supported the proposals. The legislative proposals will facilitate the use of new fuels by vessels and help promote the development of Hong Kong into a green maritime fuel bunkering center. I implore members to support the bill so that it can be passed and implemented as early as possible with a view to turning Hong Kong into a green port and consolidating our position as an international maritime center. I so submit. Thank you, Deputy President. I now propose a question to you that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
This Council resumes the second reading debate on the Statute Law Miscellaneous Provisions Bill 2024. Professor Priscilla Leung, Chairman of the Bills Committee on the Bill, will first